We told you consultants were looking to make cuts in two big departments in the school district, athletics and the police department. Tonight, they identified places where they can make some of those cuts. KFTM's Justin Hinton is back from that meeting. He joins us now with what they have presented to cut and what else they discussed. Justin?
Well, those identified cuts took place in the second meeting. Up first, they discussed taxes. Right now, the interim CFO is proposing a tax increase of a little more than 2 cents. That would raise the tax rate to about $1.34, meaning for a $100,000 home, you can expect to pay about $18 to $20 a year, or $18 to $20 more a year. Now, they wrapped that hearing up and went directly to the budget, and here's what consultants presented. With help from the police department, they identified $500,000 in cuts the board could make. Those cuts would come from doing away with 8 positions, reducing stipends, reducing the rank of several officers, and reducing the number of days worked. The consultants are still looking at how much it would cost to contract some of the work performed. The Board of Managers also heard about the athletics program. Though there was no exact amount given in identified cuts, consultants are looking at cutting down the total amount in stipends coaches received. Right now, it's at $1.2 million. That comes from extra duties and extra days worked. But the interim CFO explains that's not all they're looking at.
When we look at the overall athletic budget, we're not talking just football, basketball. We're talking about girls sports, we're talking about tennis, we're talking about powerlifting, we're talking about wrestling. These do not generate revenue, but they generate cost. And when you look at, you have it at 3 different campuses and you have boys and girls events, it's an expense. Then we have to have transportation to transport them to other schools and things of this nature. So, you know, there's a number of things to be considered.
I also spoke with Athletic Director Rodney Savette. He says he's also working to identify areas that can be reduced. Now, the goal was originally to generate about $17 million worth in cuts total. But after revenue came in from reimbursements from Medicaid, the tax base, and a few other areas, the district is now looking at about $10 to $11 million in cuts. Kelly?